Hey guys, back with another reaction video. The request is for Gentle Giant. This is a band I know well. It was one of my dad's favorite bands, a very underrated band. The song here is Funny Ways. This is a live version. Probably have heard the song before, you know, growing up in the house from my dad. Still have a lot of their discography though to get through. So yeah, let's get to this. 3, 2, 1, go. Oh yeah, I do recognize this. Oh man. The only thing that's taken away, I'm sorry, I might ruin this song for some of you, but this is what has hit me. Is that the progression from James Bond? It's got that sort of rising, falling thing that reminds me of the James Bond theme. I mean, it's 74. Not sure of the chronology here. Love the syncopation. Right, so these guys, for anybody who doesn't know, these guys are ridiculously talented, related to one another. You know, there's brothers or cousins or something like that in the band. I wouldn't be surprised that in the course of this live performance, these guys kind of jump from one instrument to another. Don't love the electric violin sound, you know, but I appreciate it has to be heard in a rock band. You know, I'm not criticizing him, by the way. I'm just saying the actual sound of an electric violin always sounds a wee bit strange to me. I've never really quite got used to it before. You know, probably Vanessa May was the first person I ever heard playing electric violin. Maybe that scarred me, who knows. But yeah, they do well to get this across in a rock band, you know. So obviously they have to go electronic. And it's not just a case of being able to play different instruments, it's being able to play them exceptionally well. They're so good. Very atmospheric. Whoa! Not expecting those kind of chords. Minor, major. So much of a bar, but in my own funny ways I find the love. What you think? So that to me, this is a perfect example of how music can be very creative and go off at tangents, but for me, it holds my attention wherever it goes. Very unexpected twists and turns, but very natural sounding twists and turns, not kicking you off at such a tangent. It's like, whoa, where are we now? You know, they do go off in a fairly surprising way when you first hear where they're going, but it seems that you know, it transitions so smoothly and seamlessly. In the 5/8 or 5/4 there. I like the fact that the other guy who was on the bass at the start, he was obviously the bassist. Not to go to the violins, so now the singer's taking up the bass. Very clever way to keep all the instruments going. Otherwise it's like, hey, who's gonna play the bass? That you never would understand the way of life. I must say, you know, just, you know, anybody who's watched some of these videos by now, you get to know that I just keep everything honest, you know, and there's something that bugs me about it. I feel like I might as well say, I'm not trying to be a dick, I just want to, you know, try and be as open and honest in terms of my opinions. Otherwise, I don't really see the point in doing a reaction video. So it did take me a while to get used to the singer. When I first heard his voice, you know, now it's been a few years, obviously, since, I might have heard this band when I was a kid, sort of in the background with all the other bands. My dad used to play Iron Maiden, Black Sabbath, Wishbone Ash, John Miles, and all classical stuff, you know, big mix of stuff. They maybe just weren't on my radar that much back then. And I got into them a few years ago. But it took me a couple of goes before I finally started to like them. You know, I just hold my hands up. I did find the singer's voice off-putting. Just his style or something like that. I just didn't really get, didn't really like at first. But I enjoyed the music so much that I sort of persevered through it. And then eventually, you know, just, you know, I just came to just enjoy it, you know, and, you know, actually really love his voice now as part of the band. It's certainly idiosyncratic and, you know, not the sort of normal kind of rock, prog rock kind of voice that you would expect. But it's neither is their music, you know, these guys are kind of doing their own thing. So I guess, you know, actually sort of like the fact now that his voice is so unique sounding, because it kind of goes with the fact that the music is so unique. So just in case any of you are a wee bit sort of touchy on the vocals, bear with them, because, you know, I actually came to really like the singer. Understand the way of life and never very tight band. One, two, three, four. Love these pauses. Who's leading this, I wonder? Okay. Here we go. We're in 7 here. Yeah. Again, showcasing their talent. Name the instrument, this guy's gonna be able to play it. Organ solo time. Wow. Kinda like a fanfare there. Yeah, good energy in this. Kind of heavy. I kind of feel like this guy is leading the pack right now. Oh. Oh, here we go. This is a vibraphone. My goodness. Pure jazz, really, here? Alright, let's stop a wee second. I mean, it's so rare to get somebody in a band of the talent of one of these guys, never mind the fact that, you know, several members in this band are just, insanely talented. I mean, this guy was playing a cello earlier on. He was on the organ and now he's on. I mean, I think it's a vibraphone. It sounds too metallic to be a marimba. Again, I'm not talking about just, oh yeah, I can play vibraphone and playing chopsticks on it. Is this improvised, I wonder? It's got a very improvisatory, that's a hard word to say for me, nature. Camera work's a bit ropey here, zooming in on his face. Get me, I want to see that vibraphone. This has to be improvised, it feels so improvised. The rest of the guys locking that groove in. Jesus Christ. Holy shit. Let me just point something out here, right? So I've already said, this guy's amazing. There's no denying that. But beyond that, he's not. Like, I might make a mistake here, so I'll do this. He's fully, like, so animated. I mean, just how good is this? Camera work is crap. Zoom out. I mean, at this point, he might as well just be playing whack-a-mole. That is so annoying, the camera work. The band's slowly ramping it up. Drummer adding in the snare now. It's a slight pity it's over the James Bond chord progression. Wow. Where's the round of applause? And that seems odd to me. That's so sparse, and that was so clearly a solo. And there's clear, I mean, there's people in the background there. It says live. You know, it is live. I mean, it looks like a TV performance or something. So maybe it is a very sparse crowd. Maybe they've been told not to clap. I don't know. But that kind of feels awkward to me, that somebody can play the best vibraphone solo you're ever likely to hear in your life and then be like, meh. You remember this triangle. Nice. I think the band has started to find a bit of a renaissance in terms of people appreciating their music, you know, this time a lot later. You know, this was 10 years before I was born, so obviously, you know, I wasn't able to appreciate them the first time around. But obviously in my generation, you kind of be under a rock if you're into prog and never have heard of Stephen Wilson. You know, and you know, Stephen Wilson has been involved in remixing some Gentle Giant stuff and putting it out. So I think that has given them a bit of a resurgence. You know, so I can see we're on 670,000 views, which is, you know, I mean, that's pretty high considering, you know, they're a fairly obscure prog band. I mean, within the prog world, I think a lot of people will have heard of them, like, but it's nice to see them starting to get a bit of recognition. You know, I think at the time they probably blew a lot of people's minds that were like, no, let's just stick to Led Zeppelin. You know, Led Zeppelin are class, don't get me wrong. These guys are on a different planet. Another band that sounds incredibly musically educated, you know, I guess that is possibly something that could, you know, put people off, you know, if you're coming from a punk kind of raw kind of rock kind of place, maybe the violins and the cellos and stuff might seem a bit pretentious. I love it, you know, I grew up taking classical piano lessons all my life, so I love classical music, and so hearing classical instrumentation within rock music. I love it, and these guys are masters of it. So, yeah.
Was love. So you see what I mean with all my
friends. Think of the effort that must go in shipping these guys' instruments from gig to gig. There's no software going on here, no laptop and a MIDI keyboard. Oh!
But in my own funny ways, I find to learn much more.
Yeah. You can tell from the way these guys are playing, these guys have to be classically trained. You know, the drummers, I don't mean this to sound the wrong way, but he doesn't sound like just a drummer. He sounds like a percussionist, the way he's playing the drums. There's the round of applause. Weird edit, because there's nobody clapping. Alright, come on, get up! That was amazing. Like, thanks for this request. Love this band. Love them. See you all next time.